know we got brain damage, and sometimes we can't manage. No time, it cannot fix it. Often we get explicit, can't channel our aggressions. They make that first impression. This here ain't no confession. Don't need your effing blessings. Case. Why do I rob your banks? Why do I jack your moves? Why do I run from chase? They call me Michael Nothing, but screw them, I am something. I am your CJ Prophet, and terror, you can't stop it. I'll put sparks on your Ashton. I am your Daniel Faith. I'm Raz, I am the champion, and no, I'm not Colombian. I do pop ecstasy, I have anxiety. Put anthrax on your G-spot monkey, you ain't hot as me. I'm landing, yes, I'm Ramus. Like Phoenix, yes, I'm famous. Watch Moro whack that dick. Joy balls won't take your ish. Vortex gon' bleed like Kotex. Scorpion gon' give you suplex. Baller ball gon' get that bread. Hit me like Corn and Craig.
All right, TV title on the line. Can Ashton get that monkey off his back? I don't think so.
Oh, it's going to be huge. The cocky cover boy.
There might not be a more hated guy right now than that piece of work in the ring.
Because they're jealous of him. Look at him. He is everything they want to be.
Magazine covers, movies, television shows, they don't mean crap when you step in the squared circle. And the one thing that Ashton cannot seem to do is win the TV title back. Ashton might be successful in all other ventures of his entertainment career, but this man right here has got his number.
Forget about it. This man is not one-tenth the cocky cover boy. All right, here he comes. What a showboater.
And Landon Ramos makes his entrance, the television champion of TWF, Landon Ramos, who's held every belt there is to offer here in TWF. Of course, trained by Lance Storm, you all know that. But what I am going to say is Landon Ramos has an answer for just about every kind of wrestler in the world. Landon Ramos, TV champion, can he beat Ashton? I don't know. Jaw-jacking going on right now. the cocky cover boy versus the human effing highlight reel. TV title on the... You don't want to slap him like that. And now here they go. Here we go.
It's on. You know what the big difference between these two guys are, Jacoby Jones?
What?
I'll tell you, real women, like Ashton, and not some prepubescent women who like Landon Ramos. I'll tell you that much.
Oh, really?
That's his fan base, 13-year-old girls.
I think that's actually Ashton's fan base. If you really think about it, Dick Pearsall, Ashton now, as he always does at the beginning of these big matches he's in, he takes a breather 9 seconds into it. Why is that?
He's just psyching himself up.
Now what he's doing is he's stalling because he knows no one, and I mean no one, can out-wrestle Landon Ramos. No one is more technically sound than Landon Ramos, and Ashton needs an ulterior plan to succeed tonight.
We're going to see if Landon Ramos loses that 10 pounds of gold around his waist.
Of course, you can see that huge scaffold in the background. Gives me goosebumps just looking at it. They're in the corner now. Nice shot by Landon.
That scaffold's so big.
Look at that. Two knees to the chest.
Two of our fans actually got cranes in their neck and had to leave because of that scaffold. Looking up at the top of that.
And nice move by Landon. Spinning heel kick. Don't blink because you'll miss the lightning fast offense of Landon Ramos. He is on him like flies on cow poop.
The cocky cover boy better find something to slow this guy down.
Shoots him in now. And a spin kick right to the million-dollar face of Ashton. And now Landon squeezing on him.
He is like a whirling dervish in there. Look at that.
Belly-to-back suplex, and Ashton doesn't even have time to recover between this offense. Nice acai moonsault off the second rope. Vintage Landon Ramos, and Ashton can't even get out of the blocks here.
The whole thing about Landon Ramos is you've got to slow him down.
Yep, Ashton needs to make him fight his game, and thus far he's been unsuccessful. Shoots him in now. There you go. Using that 6 foot 4 inch frame to his advantage with a big boot to the jaw.
Very smart move. Keep him at a distance.
If there is an Achilles heel, so to speak, on Landon, it is that jaw. It was broken last year. Hanging high. Vertical suplex by Ashton.
And that's a long way down. That's almost as tall as the scaffolding.
There's that acai moonsault one more time. Unable to capitalize. Here we go.
Wow.
And hangs him throat first on the top rope.
Ashton showing some strength.
Definitely Ashton now, after being, I'll put it bluntly, getting the crap beat out of him for the first few minutes. Ashton now returning the favor to Landon Ramos. The television title is on the line. Ashton has held that belt before.
Well, I'll tell you something. I was talking to Ashton backstage. He really wants this belt. Oh, in a bad, bad way.
Yeah, he might. You can want it all you want, but you have to get the job done in the squared circle. Pinfall attempt after that thunderous clothesline. Only a two count, though. It's going to take a lot more than that to put away the legend that is Landon Ramos.
Well, he, just like me, don't really like Landon Ramos.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I respect the hell out of the guy, and I'm proud to call him a friend. Shoots him in now. Oh, no. Oh, flying forearm. Nice agility displayed by the human effing highlight reel. One more boot to the million-dollar face.
Damn it. Get up, Ashton.
It looks like Ashton got his hair frosted. I wonder if that's for a movie role or something.
He's always doing something.
Sit out. Gourd Buster. Nicely done by Landon. Rolls him over. I'm not sure what he's thinking. He's on the top rope, though.
He is one of the most photographed TWF superstars.
Whoa! He went for the home run. He went for the grand slam. He went for it all with the shooting star press, but unable to capitalize on that opportunity.
Much like his love life is a little premature. Look at this. Nobody home.
Very spectacular, but unable to connect.
He went for the money shot, and Ashton was not soft enough yet. Look at the terrible turn.
And now Ashton sends him very hard to the outside. Landon Ramos trying to shake off the cobwebs now. Landon Ramos in trouble.
The cocky cover boy's got things going his way. Whoa!
Suicide dive onto the outside. Puts life and limb at risk in the name of the TV title. And Landon is in serious trouble.
That's what I'm talking about, Jacoby Jones. How bad does Ashton want this belt?
Oh, I know he dreams about this belt.
Look at that.
Oh, Yeah, that's a very, very lanky individual soaring through the air to try to win himself a title. Puts him back in the ring now where he can win it. Clubs him in the back with a forearm.
Landing on concrete and still working over Landon Ramos.
Body slam places him in position for something. I'm not sure what. Ashton now thinking top rope.
He better stay on top. Don't give him time to recover. That's what I'm talking about.
It took him too long to get up there, and Landon Ramos recovered enough to catch him in no man's land.
Ashton wanted to put him away with one shot.
And the opposite might happen. Oh! Superplex! Superplex off the top!
That was a super duperplex. Man, that was... Oh!
And someone as tall as Ashton is going to feel that a lot more.
Look at that!
Oh! Due to his very tall stature, down he goes.
His feet almost scraped the top of the ceiling, and this is a very tall ceiling.
Ah, Landon Ramos went for a leapfrog, and Ashton made him pay the price with a shot to the family jewels.
That was a thing of absolute beauty.
Yeah, that was a devious mind definitely thinking in that squared circle. That's what that was. Shot to the top of the head, and Landon is reeling.
Ashton him, showing him what it's done, showing him how bad he wants the belt, about to take it now. Yes.
Power bomb by the challenger. The champion is definitely in trouble. The challenger needs to stay on him, though. Ashton needs to string together some big moves if he wants to win the title, the TV title, here tonight.
Ashton's got everything in life. He's got the girls. Oh, look at that. He's got the money, the car, the fame. All he needs is some gold to go with it.
Well, Ashton went on the outside to try to find some sort of weapon, but Landon Ramos is pulling him back in the hard way. It's like in Grand Theft Auto when you pull someone out of a car.
Jacking the car. This time he's jacking the wrestler.
Oh, what balance displayed by Landon. Able to dip Ashton down. I'm not sure what Landon's thinking on the outside there.
He's getting something.
Oh, that, my friends, is a steel chair and changes the complexion of this thing in a hurry. Oh, he missed the spin kick. Oh, he missed the trip. Down he goes. Oh, corkscrew leg drop. Nicely done.
He had an answer for everything except that last move.
Oh, what a sequence. And at the end of it, Landon puts that chair into Ashton's face. Watch this.
Outsmarts him there, but third time's a charm.
Oh, absolutely beautiful. Whoever said TWF couldn't wrestle is full of crap, bar none.
Meanwhile, can Landon Ramos hit that one home run shot? No!
And once again, Landon trying to polish off Ashton fails to do so, and Ashton knows when to move.
That's a big, big part of it. How well you can keep your man thinking that you're down when you're not really down. It's called a swerve. And meanwhile, look at that.
Butterfly effect, it's over.
I love this move.
Oh, close, very close, but no cigar. We thought Landon might have been done. Ashton hits his coup de grace, but Landon too tough.
I'm going to have to complain.
Oh, wait a second.
I'm going to have to complain. I thought her count was a little slow, too.
What are you talking about? He just clubbed Tara and then clubbed Landon. That's going to cost him some bucks clubbing the commissioner.
She's got to be unbiased when she calls these matches.
Oh, he caught him.
Oh, damn it.
Oh, Impaler Stunner.
Oh, man.
Oh, if he hits the frog splash, that's it.
Wait a second.
What the hell? It's Corey Sparks and CJ Profit. What are you guys doing? Oh, choke bomb. No, come on.
Who's there to count? Tara's out.
Landon Ramos trained those guys for the wrestling business. Landon Ramos showed them how to be pro wrestlers, and this is how they repay him? No.
And the teacher gets taught a lesson.
Only two. Despite the interference of those two ungrateful sons of bitches, Landon Ramos kicked out.
How good of a teacher can he be? He can't even teach two guys to beat him down and keep him down, for crying out loud.
Those two leeches have... what a DDT. Those two leeches at ringside.
Ashton's got to do things.
Leave Tara alone. Well, CJ Profit and Corey Sparks at ringside have turned their back on Landon, and yeah, they're drinking the Kool-Aid of Ashton, I think.
Well, they joined up, obviously, for this match to help out Ashton.
Oh, reversal. Reversal into the Hurricane Rana. Landon is getting the job done despite the circumstances. Oh, we've got another ref. We've got another ref. Crystal's in there. Thank God. Thank God. Frog splash.
One, two. What happened? She broke a nail. Jacoby, I think she broke a nail.
What the hell is that?
What do you mean? It's an injury. It's called an injury.
Why is Crystal not counting? Why is Crystal the ref not counting?
She tried to. She got injured.
What is she thinking? Oh, cheap shot by Ashton. This stinks. This whole situation reeks. What is going on?
Landon Ramos has got to think the deck stacked against him. Oh,
what a move.
Here we go. One, two. Oh, wait a second. That's three.
What the hell? What the? No. What? Ashton is the new television champion of TWF? They were in cahoots all along. What the hell is going on? How did this happen?
Ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner, the cocky cover boy,
Oh, here comes Jack Moves. Here comes Rob Banks to try to get these guys, to try to beat these guys, to try to even the damn odds. This is horrible. Ashton is the new television champion. Oh, double big boot.
Ashton found a way to do it.
Oh, what a move by CJ Profit. And now CJ Profit, Corey Sparks, Crystal, and Ashton have revealed to the world that they were all in cahoots all along, and the plan was successfully executed, because we've got a new, by hook or by crook, a new TV champion.
That was a thing of absolute beauty. It played out like a Harry Potter novel.
Well, Ashton came in with a plan. Ashton came in by any means necessary tonight at Brain Damage. He would capture the TV title. And as much as I hate to admit it,
he had an answer for everybody.
That is exactly what he did.
You go celebrate, cocky cover boy. You deserve it.
All right, watch this travesty of justice unfold before your very eyes. Yeah, turncoats. Oh, Landon trains you for the business, and this is how you repay him. Then he throws Tara outside the ring. A frog splash later, it should have been over.
One, two, and you saw it. A nail broke. Clearly you saw it.
A nail didn't break. That was a woman that turned her back on the company that employs her. Oh, look at that move. Yeah, fast count later from a damn crooked referee. We've got a new television champion, and there's nothing we can do about it.
I've got to applaud that whole...
Fans get a big thrill when their favorite wrestler is about to make his entrance.
Woo! They scream, or boo! They go. And here to present the Dragula Best Entrance Award for this year is a guy that gets a lot of the boos, if you know what I'm saying. He's a hell of a competitor. I'll give him that. He's a hell of a competitor. He's a friend of this guy. Boo! That man,
like this,
that man went Hollywood lately. His name is Joey.
Give it up!
Yeah!
Hallmark moment.
Very good.
Hey.
That's more specific. He should have won the first award.
Hey. Who's the balls?
After you.
Take your balls.
The Iron Man.
Never mind.
2005. TWF. Dragula Best Entrance Award.
What do they call the Dragula Best?
I don't know. He didn't even have good entrances anyway.
I know.
It was Dragula. Yeah. What a freak.
I know some other guys who do a really better entrance.
Real quick, let me remind the audience at home. Zoom into me. The people who won 2004's Entrance of the Year was Business 80. Give him a hand.
Hypnotic.
Oh. That's right. Don't forget it.
Now, who's going to win this year?
I won.
This year's winner, 2005, is none other.
Who's the ball?
Dick, come here.
Who's the ball?
Oh, what's going on here? Come on, Dick. Tell us.
Am I reading this? Tell me I'm not reading this.
Come on, DB. Dick, the ball.
This is a travesty.
That's what it says. This is a travesty of justice. Who am I kidding? It's Business 80.
I give you the greatest faction in professional wrestling today, Business
80, buddy!
80!
They don't deserve it.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, you do not deserve to say this.
No.
But just because we're in the greatest spirits.
Yes.
And we're so happy that we won this award.
Again. You all are going to get the witness.
Best Entrance Year of the War.
Yes. The Warrior Workout.
Note from our part.
Once in a lifetime.
What?
The greatest group of individuals come along.
The greatest group of individuals.
And it gets retarded.
That's us.
That's us. That's Business 80, bitches.
And you will never see anything better because
we're
you
here
are
to stay.
Old people.
And as long as Business 80 exists, we will always get the entrance of the year.
The entrance of the year.
I got it with the Dragula Best Entrance Award.
You're now just a John Cena.
This is the
Speak up because you know you admire us.
We still got 10 more. Pause!
10 more minutes!
Yeah! Oh, what this drunken fool!
Hey, somebody take this man off my hands!
Oh! You wanna get physical? We can get physical! Come and get some! Now what? Physical!
We should got some!
Ooh, wait!
Gus!
Yeah, we should
got some! Alright, ladies and gentlemen! One time only!
One time only!
Let me get out of here! Let me get in here! Oh! You can't beat this! You can't beat this! Yeah, baby! What? Mr. Sandy wins again!
Yeah!
Woo! Booth passed out.
You want some? Come get some, like John Cena says, but that means I'm a faggot, so never mind. I don't want nothing about John Cena. I'll kill you! I'll kill you! I'll kill you too!
Sacramento area, Channel 18, Mondays at 8, Wednesdays at 11. West Sacramento, Channel 21, Fridays and Saturdays, 10 p.m. Davis, Channel 15, Thursdays, 10 p.m. Stockton area, Saturdays, 11:30 p.m. Oh, I'm out of breath.
Do you want to be a wrestler?
I don't know, do you?
I don't know. If you got what it takes, you know where to check out.
Landon_Ramos@hotmail.com. Email Landon if you want to join TWF. Three falls. Two of the most athletic guys on the roster. Who's going to win, Dick Pearsall?
I have one answer for you. Anthrax!
Oh, you think so?
I know so.
My money's on the other guy, Michael Nothing. It's going to happen right now. Arrogance. A flat-out arrogant athlete right there. but a damn good one at that. Former TWF champion Anthrax, and very conspicuous by his absence, is G-Spot tonight.
Jacoby Jones, I have no idea what the hell's going on with G-Force. There he is. Oh, he's looking fine. I mean, it's fit. You know what I'm saying.
Ew.
Don't give any. Don't even start it.
And his opponent is one of a kind. His opponent, these fans love him. His opponent is Mr. Nothing.
He is one mean hombre. I'll give him that.
And nearly 200 people at the Colonial Theater appreciate Michael Nothing. But who will win this game of one-upsmanship? All summer long, it's been Anthrax and Michael Nothing going back and forth, nearly killing each other in the process. Who will win 2 out of 3 falls here tonight?
Best 2 out of 3 falls with the following stipulations. Fall number 1, won by submission. Fall number 2, tables match. Fall number 3, pinfall. And introducing today's combatants. Introducing first, one of the hottest superstars in TWF today.
Here we go. 2 out of 3 falls. The first fall will be decided by submission. The second fall is a table match. And the third fall is the good old pinfall. This will be a classic. This is right now waistlock by Anthrax. Nice reach around by Michael Nothing.
You said it, Jacoby Jones. This match is going to be a barn burner. I can't wait to see these two lock it up.
Well, they're already doing it.
Very nice.
Nothing able to drop him on his face and now squeezing on the right arm of Anthrax. Oh, and look at Anthrax trying to get out of it, but Michael Nothing hangs on.
You know, there's not much I like about Michael Nothing. Wait. You know what I like about Michael Nothing?
What?
His girlfriend. I said it, Jacoby Jones.
Hey, she wouldn't appreciate that.
Oh, she loves me. Let me just say this, though. You are going to see, ladies and gentlemen at home, two of the finest technical wrestlers in the business today.
Oh, look at that. Speaking of technical, nice reversal there by Michael Nothing. Both of these gentlemen are very athletically gifted. Both of these guys are former TWF champions, so they can definitely get it done in the squared circle, both trying to top each other all summer long in TWF.
Just like I was saying, Jacoby Jones, I don't like much about Michael Nothing, but he can wrestle.
Well, of course, last month at Revengeance, oh, look at this, nice reversal. At Revengeance, they were involved in the 6-man Falls Count Anywhere main event, and the very end of that match saw Anthrax leap off a table and powerbomb Michael Nothing through a table, or leap off a ladder. Nice arm drag, look at that.
Look at the speed and agility.
One more time, Michael Nothing squeezing on Anthrax after very, very technically sound arm drags moments ago.
We talk about our wrestling school and our mini infomercials there, Jacoby Jones. And I'll tell you something, kids at home, if you're watching this and you go to wrestling school, maybe, just maybe someday, you could be half as good as one of these guys.
Oh, man. Kicked him right in the damn face. German suplex, perhaps.
Does he have the strength?
Well, Anthrax trying to block it with every ounce of strength he's got. A couple elbows.
Look at that.
Into the hammerlock once again. These guys are putting on a wrestling clinic for all you fans. De La Rosa body scissors.
Anthrax with the height and weight advantage, but man, oh man, Michael Nothing's quick as a cat.
Into an arm drag, and Michael Nothing, oh, goes for the dropkick.
Oh.
Anthrax blocks it.
Hell no, turn him over.
Boston Crab, perhaps, trying to turn him over.
There we go.
He's got the knee planted in his spine, and Michael Nothing not very close to the ropes.
This is submission, and you could very well see this match end in submission because both of these guys know plenty, oh, plenty of submission holds.
Well, that is the stipulation of the first fall is submission, and Anthrax
definitely
doing the smart thing, trying to wear down Michael Nothing. Nice leverage move there by Nothing. Turns him over now.
I mentioned it in the intro, Jacoby Jones. Have you mentioned it yet that the two out of three,
yes.
First one is
submission.
Second one is...
Oh, table match.
Oh, and the third one, a good old pinfall.
Exactly. And Michael Nothing squeezing with the vice grips.
Ooh. Oh,
with the vice grips of his legs on the head, on the cranium of Anthrax. Anthrax trying to get out of it.
Oh.
And Michael Nothing slamming him down. Mini pile drivers, if you will.
Man.
Oh, but Anthrax, able to use that athleticism, squirts out of it, and then drop kicks him in the face now. Anthrax has Michael Nothing in a very precarious position.
Close to the ropes. Can Michael Nada grab that rope? He's reaching for it. Nope.
Well, Anthrax
picks him up. Too smart.
Anthrax realized how close he was to the ropes. Here we go.
Very smart. Now he's putting the offensive moves. Look at that kip up.
And did you hear him scream the F word at the crowd? Yeah, very cool, Anthrax.
Well,
watch this.
The 8 o'clock crowd didn't hear that.
Nice technical wrestling, and watch this.
Look at that kip up. Come on now.
Amazing agility and an even cruddier mouth.
he's got the mouth of a sailor. Oh!
Leg lariat across the jawbone, and Anthrax now really asserting himself in this thing. We've got nearly 200 people here at Brain Damage to watch the madness, to watch the insanity.
He's got the mouth of a sailor and the moves of a wrestling Adonis.
Yep, definitely so. Very gifted is Anthrax. I'll give him that. His attitude leaves something to be desired.
Remember when he used to be loved? Do you remember, Jacoby Jones, how loved this man used to be?
Well, as he squeezes on Michael Nothing, yes, I realize that Anthrax at one time was probably the most popular guy on the roster. Those days are over, though, since joining up with G-Force.
Now his own mother doesn't even speak to him.
Yep, now his own mother has disowned him. As far as she's concerned, he is not her son anymore.
His own mother doesn't speak to him, but you know something, Double J, I know his mother, and that's a gift. That's a blessing.
Don't you say that. She's a very nice woman.
Oh!
And Anthrax plows through Michael Nothing, who had the same idea, but Anthrax had more speed, more leverage, more body weight, and Michael Nothing feeling the effects of that lariat.
Hell yeah, now he's talking smack. I love it.
Yeah, if he talks too much, though, and ignores the problem at hand for him, which is Nothing, he'll get his face kicked off.
Oh.
Speaking of kicks, oh, man.
Oh, man, that guy could chop a tree down with those kicks.
Oh. Talk about stiff. Michael Nothing's right foot just got him back in this thing with a series of crazy stiff kicks. Now he's working on the right leg of Anthrax, or maybe the left. I think it's the left.
And this is the type of match going to have turns exactly that quickly because both these men can reverse anything.
Well, it might be smart for Michael Nothing to work on the legs of Anthrax. It has a double-pronged effect. First, he could maybe get a submission, but second of all, he can ground Anthrax. Oh, that'll ground anyone.
I'd give up right now.
But he could ground him if he injures one of those legs from a lot of Anthrax's offense is leaping off that top rope. Oh!
Soften up an extremity and then go to work on it and then go ahead and twist it until he quits.
Oh, really?
That's the way it works.
Wow! Oh, swinging neck breaker executed by Michael Nothing. Now he's going to squeeze on Anthrax, trying to get that submission and win the first fall here.
Michael Nothing knows a lot of moves, a lot of submission moves.
Oh, yeah, Michael Nothing, very schooled in the submissions, definitely used that to his advantage in a normal matchup, but this matchup, the first fall is submissions, so my hat would be tipped toward Michael Nothing to win this first fall.
You kind of have to give it to him. That man can make you submit just by shaking your hand.
Oh, what power! What absolute power by Anthrax to get out of a very, very tough predicament.
Hell yeah. And you can't, you know, you can't ever make up for power. All the speed in the world, give me... That's right. Give me power any day of the week. You tell him, Anthrax.
Well, Anthrax has both. Watch this one more time. Hoists him up.
Look at this.
Oh, very rough landing as far as Michael Nothing is concerned. Anthrax now takes control back. That offensive momentum, that pendulum has swung back in his direction. Now Anthrax perched on the ropes with Michael Nothing.
The big move, that's what Thrax's forte is.
Could we see Hurricane Rana or something? I don't know. Anthrax now paintbrushing the face of Michael Nothing.
Softening him up.
Knee to the stomach. Oh, he caught him. Backflip. He landed on his feet.
That's agility.
Oh, and he caught the legs. He caught the legs of Michael Nothing. He went for a missile drop kick, but Anthrax was a smidge quicker. Oh, no. And now squeezing on the anatomy.
It. That's it. He telegraphed the missile drop kick, and Anthrax takes advantage. This could be it, Jacoby Jones. That's it.
And Michael Nothing has no choice but to tap out. Anthrax had it cinched on like a pit bull on the mailman's neck. And Anthrax has taken the first fall here tonight at Brain Damage. Yeah, it's 1-0 your advantage. Yeah, you don't have to tell everyone. They know. Well, if we could see that one more time, watch this. Watch the agility. Lands on his feet, Michael Nothing thinking missile drop kick, but Anthrax able to catch the feet, turn him over in the center of the ring, and there was nothing Michael Nothing could do.
Look at the knee right in the small of the back.
Definitely pain personified, but Anthrax now a huge advantage by taking that first fall. Oh, DDT on his head, and now the second fall begins, and it's now a table match.
Michael Nothing with his back against the wall. There's no room to go. He loses this match. He loses.
Oh, boy. And Anthrax does not waste any time whatsoever in dragging out the heavy artillery.
Here it is.
And you know what? He's not going to place a wedding cake on that table.
Hell no.
He's not going to put a tablecloth on it and serve Michael Nothing Sunday dinner. He wants to put him through it and win this match here tonight.
We've already got the merchandise desk behind him all set up to buy your fine TWF merchandise. This table's for one thing and one thing only. Oh, but Michael Nothing knows that and catches him with an elbow.
Well, Anthrax took his eyes off the prize for too long. It took him too long to set up that table. Oh, and now Michael Nothing making him pay the piper.
Suplex.
If he puts him through it, Michael Nothing will even this thing 1-1.
Could he catch him that quick?
If Anthrax puts him through it, though, Anthrax wins the match. Michael Nothing blocking it.
Oh, this could be it. Reversal. Oh, look at that.
And both guys are jockeying for position. Oh, boy. Anthrax now flipped upside down.
He's in a bad way.
Oh, and kicked right in the top of his skull.
Look at him, hung out to dry.
Oh, Michael Nothing is not done. Very vicious knee to the abdomen area, and now he's cupping his head.
Oh, and he's... Oh, dropping him right on the cement.
Reverse DDT, Dick Pearsall. That is Concussion City.
Right now, Miguel Nada's got everything going his way.
Definitely so. Now, Michael, I'm not sure what he's looking for under the ring, but watch this. Boom! Yeah, that thud that echoes off the walls is Anthrax's head hitting the concrete floor. And Michael Nothing has another table.
Oh, what the hell, Michael Nothing? One table isn't good enough for you. Now you got in another one?
Well, maybe you up your options times two if you bring a second one into the fold. You only got to put him through one table to win the second fall. But if you got tables everywhere, you never know where an opportunity might show itself. Michael Nothing using his noggin, if you will.
Well, maybe that's like his table and he has sentimental value.
I don't know. Maybe it was the table that he ate his first meal when he was a little kid 20-something years ago. Who knows? But whatever the case may be, Anthrax getting his face slammed on the table. And I guess if the table breaks and he slams his face on it, that counts like putting him through it, right?
Well, Tara, the crooked ref, crooked commissioner would probably say yes.
Wow, slingshot leg drop, and Michael Nothing softening up Anthrax for some sort of table opportunity. You gotta think it. Oh, here we go.
And you know Tara's not a big fan of Anthrax or G-Force.
Well, look what they've done to her over the the past, what, 4 or 5 months or so. Jeez, I'm surprised she doesn't suspend and fine them. But she knows people pay good money to see G-Force get beat up. That's what she knows. Oh, and Michael Nothing made the cardinal mistake of turning his back for too long, and Anthrax made him pay.
Oh, this is it. One German later, and he walks away with the... Wait.
Oh.
God damn it.
Don't count your chickens before they hatch, Dick Pearsall. Close, but no cigar.
So close.
Anthrax trying to top rope German, but Michael Nothing, able to fight it off, puts that table in a little bit of a different position. I'm not sure what's going through his head at this moment.
Damn it, Thrax, you were so close.
Here we go, here we go.
Look at that, I didn't know where he was at.
Oh, what agility displayed by Michael Nothing after Anthrax runs face first into the corner, then he gets the springboard clothesline. Michael Nothing definitely in control.
Wow, he's going all Chris Angel on him. If one minute he's there, next minute he wasn't there, Anthrax looking around and then bang.
The mind freak.
Look at this. Right now, Anthrax is in a very, very bad way.
Well, Michael Nothing puts him in the corner. Anthrax, boot to the stomach.
Desperation boot. Caught him, though.
Oh! And that could be a difference maker right there. Anthrax sees an opening, drops him on his damn head with a pile driver.
Desperation pile driver, but it worked perfectly.
Straight South Jerry Lawler style pile driver. That had to hurt. That had to do a bad thing. Back to live action now, though. Michael Nothing recovers just enough to crotch Anthrax on that top rope.
That table is just waiting for someone to go. Both tables are just waiting for someone to go through it.
Oh, no. Here comes Nothing. He's on the top rope. Anthrax still stunned from that crotch shot moments ago, trying to swing back with some punches, first to the face, then to the abdomen.
They're jockeying for position.
Fireman's carry, perhaps. I can't quite tell. Oh, this is dangerous.
Fighting for advantage.
Come on.
Oh! Oh!
He got him! Michael Nothing, last second switch, Hurricane Rana, off the top rope, through the table, and this match is even at one fall apiece, Dick Pearsall.
Wow!
Spectacular.
That was absolutely amazing.
Simply spectacular by Michael Nothing. Puts Anthrax through the table from the top rope to the damn floor. And both guys are feeling the effects. We got to see that again.
Hell yeah, look at this.
Come on!
Wow.
Man, look at the splinters.
Oh, Michael Nothing uses that leg string to push him over, to flip him over through that table. Now it's all about the pinfall. Third and deciding fall right here and right now from the Colonial Theater from Brain Damage.
That last move even had our sound man Dennis flipping out.
Yep, you could see him jump from the background there.
Man.
Thanks for all your hard work, Dennis, by the way. We appreciate you. You're one of the unsung heroes of TWF.
Full Scale Productions, we gotta plug them, you know what?
Oh yeah.
One more match, Jacoby Jones. We're all knotted up and one apiece.
Oh, and once again, Anthrax uses that low blow. It might be his best weapon all day today. Oh no, now he's climbing to the top. Oh, German suplex off the top, through the table.
That was awesome, Anthrax, but it was a match too late. That was the last match.
Yep, the last fall was decided by Anthrax getting put through the table. But here we are. Oh, about 90 seconds later, Anthrax returns the favor, but the third fall is not a table match. The third fall is pinfalls. Pinfalls only, and Anthrax needs to roll over and try and beat Michael Nothing if he wants to win this thing.
It was a thing of beauty, though.
Well, if he spent less time yapping with the capacity crowd here, if he spent less time yapping with the fans, he might have won this thing.
Those idiot fans always bothering him.
Well, he lets them get under his skin because they hate his damn guts. And I'm included in that.
Just because you pay $10 to come watch the show doesn't mean you have anything. You can say anything. You sit there with your yap shut.
Well, Anthrax can't believe the fact that Nothing just kicked out of that German through the table. Nothing had some time to recover when Anthrax was yapping with the fans. Oh, knee to the chest, and Michael Nothing is finding somehow some sort of second wind, third wind, fourth wind here with a drop kick.
And you said it, Double J. He's talking to the crowd, wasting time, jaw-jacking with the crowd, and Michael Nothing, precious time that he could be pinning him. The crowd, bad bastards. It's like the fifth man with a sixth man in basketball.
Oh, and Michael Nothing goes for that lung blower. The knees would have came down on the chest cavity, but Anthrax shoves it off. He knew exactly what was coming and knew a way to counter it.
Excellent move. Up, look at the pin.
Come on.
Click, 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 click. You hear all the cameras going off? Jacoby Jones?
Yeah, in the early 90s, a wrestler by the name of Rick the Model Martel had a spray that he came out with called Arrogance.
Ah, yes.
Well, Arrogance and Anthrax have been the same thing lately. Oh, yeah, there's the reversal of the lung blower, the reversal of what probably would have been the end. Now Anthrax hoists him up.
Oh!
Fisherman Buster, and Michael Nothing screams in pain.
Excellent move. He's just got to take advantage of it, pull him in the middle of the ring, put the shoulders down for the 1-2-3.
While both individuals have been killing each other here, this is the third and deciding fall. First fall won by Anthrax via submission. Second fall taken by Michael Nothing with a top rope hurricanrana through a table with the table stipulation. Now Anthrax climbing to the top rope here in the third fall. Pinfalls only in this fall.
Setting up for the high fly maneuver. Wow, look at the height Michael Nothing got on that drop kick.
And Anthrax once again goes straight south with his twig and berries on the top turnbuckle.
Man. Here we go. Can Michael Nothing take advantage?
Oh, he's not going to do what I think he's going to do, is he? Anthrax now taking some shots.
He's setting him up for something.
No way. No way. Oh, double stomp, double stomp. Michael Nothing puts life and limb on the line to drill two boots into the black heart of Anthrax.
That just about caved in his chest.
Wow. Well, right now is a time when Anthrax would need some heavy advice from G-Spot, his buddy, who's not here.
You said it. Oh.
Oh, I thought that was it. How Anthrax can survive a move like that is beyond me. Watch this.
Oh, man.
That is 190 pounds of Michael Nothing coming crashing down on his chest.
But you said it, Jacoby Jones. Where is G-Spot? And little things like maybe distracting the referee. Not that Anthrax needs any help to beat this guy, but I'm just saying G-Spot's absence is definitely, definitely a hindrance in this match for Anthrax, my personal opinion.
Whatever. I think it's making it an even playing field for once. Anthrax now thinking teabag. Reversal, reversal. Oh, only two.
Very quick two count.
Michael Nothing, the first to his feet. Michael Nothing now, maybe a teabag of his own. There you go, drop him on his head.
Don't even try stealing that move. That's copywritten. You'll get sued, my friend.
Oh, tainted package, flipping pile driver, reversal from Anthrax, and that guy might have just won this thing.
Absolutely beautiful. This is it. Oh!
Close only counts in horseshoes and hand grenades, Dick Pearsall. And Michael Nothing ain't done yet. Don't write him off. The fat lady has not sung yet.
Did you see how much time Tara, the crooked commissioner, is taking between counts when Michael Nothing's shoulders are down? I could have gotten a newspaper in between counts.
Are we watching the same match? The cadence of her count has been exactly the same for both guys. That's a sign of a good referee. Now Anthrax screaming at the crowd.
Oh, there's damn crowd getting in his head once again, but oh,
double knees. Oh, what a move by Nothing. And Anthrax just got a double dose of back pain over and over. Michael Nothing. Michael Nothing.
Now see there again. G would have been taking the heat from the crowd, not Anthrax. Oh, look at this. Don't let it happen. Not this way.
Double stomp!
No! That's it.
He did it! Michael Nothing has survived and defeated Anthrax in this 2 out of 3 falls epic encounter here from Brain Damage. What a damn match. Talk about your scientific classic into your crazy brawl, into your spectacular finish. This match was definitely the total package here in the Total Wrestling Federation. I am proud to say I love that thing. Well, here's some replays. Watch the tainted package, Dick. Dropped on his head.
Absolutely amazing. Look at the height. Wait, look at the few more, but look at the finishing move with Michael Nothing.
Oh, Anthrax's arrogance. Boom! Shot himself in the foot on this one.
Oh, Lord. The height that Michael Nothing comes off that top rope with that double stomp to the chest. He's got to be up 12, 13 feet in the air.
And coming down onto the chest of Anthrax.
And stomping on him.
For the second time with that maneuver.
Look at the height he gets.
Too much for Anthrax to handle or any human being.
This is just, oh, that's inhuman.
Oh, 190 pounds across the chest. 1, 2, 3. We got ourselves a winner.
That is just, how in the hell?
Michael Nothing found a way to beat a guy who's been pretty damn unbeatable the past couple months. Michael Nothing, huge, monstrous, enormous victory here tonight. Yeah, that's a nice still there.
Now, where the hell, I'm saying it again, is G-Spot to beat the crap out of Michael Nothing? That's what I want to see right now.
Well, actually, what I want to see is what we're seeing on the screen right now.
I want
to see Anthrax go to the locker room with his tail between his legs. I want Anthrax, I want him to know what it feels like to get a beating and then get embarrassed by being defeated in front of a huge crowd because you deserve it. It couldn't happen to a nicer guy, right? Anthrax.
Where's G?
Yeah, they're not out here.
Look at this.
Because there's snakes in the grass, just like that guy. And Anthrax now. Anthrax trying to recover after having his chest nearly caved in by Michael Nothing. Yeah, that guy lost tonight.
Wow. He may never be the same.
Anthrax, I have to admit, the guy is amazing in the ring. The guy is so talented. Sky's the limit with this guy. He's in his early 20s. His best days might be yet to come. He's an amazing competitor, but it feels damn good to watch him embarrassed.
There we go. On your feet. Giving the audience exactly what you think of him. Way to go, Thrax. Hats off to that man.
Yeah, go drink some champagne, you schmuck. Sacramento area, Channel 18, Mondays at 8, Wednesdays at 11. West Sacramento, Channel 21, Fridays and Saturdays, 10 p.m. Davis, Channel 15, Thursdays, 10 p.m. Stockton area, Saturdays, 11:30 p.m. Oh, I'm out of breath.
Do you want to be a wrestler?
I don't know. Do you?
I don't know. If you got what it takes, you know where to check out.
Landon_Ramos@hotmail.com. Email Landon if you want to join TWF.
Yeah. Yeah. This is it. This is the final showdown. So if you got something, if you got anything that you need to bring, you bring it now. Cause this is the final showdown. Yeah, boy.
Yeah, yeah, you're gonna bring it.
I'm gonna bring your heart, boy. You're gonna need it.
I'm gonna bring brother that too, cause I'm gonna beat it.
You're gonna bring your last right.
I guess you leave it in pieces.
Yeah, yeah, final showdown, daddy.
Yeah.
I'ma beat that ass, I'ma beat your mama. I'ma ride that bitch like a smelly llama. She smells like sushi, like Benihana. I can't think of nothing else that rhymes with mama. Yeah.
Yeah.
Final showdown, daddy.
Final showdown.
A final showdown, daddy.
Final showdown.
A final showdown, daddy.
Final showdown.
Yeah. Final showdown. Yeah. Buy some DVDs.